until 2024. So President Obama and Democrats didn't weaken Medicare, they strengthened Medicare. Now, when Congressman Ryan looked into that TV camera and attacked President Obama's Medicare savings as, quote, the biggest, coldest power play, I don't know whether to laugh or cry. Because that $716 million is exactly to the dollar the same amount of Medicare savings that he had in his own budget. You gotta get one thing, it takes some brass to attack a guy for doing what you did. I want you to listen. It's important. Because a lot of people believe this stuff. Now, at least on this issue, and this one issue, Governor Romney has been consistent. He attacked President Obama too. But he actually wants to repeal those savings and give the money back to the insurance company. He wants to go back to the old system, which means we'll reopen the donut hole and force seniors to pay more for drugs. And we'll reduce the life of the Medicare Trust Fund by 8 full years. So, if he's elected, and if he does what he promised to do, Medicare will now grow broke in 2016. Think about that. That means, after all, we won't have to wait until our voucher program kicks in 2023 to see the end of Medicare as we know it. They're going to do it to us sooner than we thought. Now, folks, this is serious because it gets worse. And you won't be laughing when I finish telling you this. They also want to block grant Medicaid and cut it by a third over the coming 10 years. Of course, that's going to really hurt a lot of poor kids. But that's not all. A lot of folks don't know it, but nearly two-thirds of Medicaid is spent on nursing home care for Medicare seniors who are eligible for Medicaid. It's going to end Medicare as we know it. And a lot of that money is also spent to help people with disabilities, including a lot of